In these shallow waters, another reclusive herbivore is searching for food. Dugongs are a bizarre sight in Indonesia's waters. And the pages of maritime history mistake these for mysterious mermaid sightings. Up close, the truth is slightly less elegant. Beneath the muscular upper lip, they have a small set of concealed tusks inherited from ancient ancestors. Their closest living relative is surprisingly found on land. The elephant. Dugongs can grow over 3 meters in length and weigh almost half a ton. This particular individual has a real appetite. Meadows of seagrass offer up a dugong delicacy. These animals spend up to 8 hours a day grazing, eating up to 50 kilos of seagrass. And like elephants, their daily harvesting helps cultivate more plant growth. As he uproots the vegetation, he disturbs the seabed, which attracts small fish. They feed on the scraps the dugong leaves behind. But these aquatic mammals must take frequent breaks to breathe at the surface. Heavy bones allow dugongs to balance their weight in the water. Adjusting their oxygen intake allows them to rise and fall with ease, if not grace. Even when sleeping, this male must drowsily return to the surface to breathe. He also needs to keep a constant watch for danger. The bright coral gardens of Indonesia's oceans become less welcoming after dark. As the sun sets, the reef's grazers must find a hiding place. With darkness, even the reef itself turns carnivorous. And a feeding frenzy is about to begin. Tiny drifting creatures called zooplankton are sucked in and consumed by the coral itself. A parrotfish settles in for the night. But before it can sleep, there is a ritual to perform. The fish excretes mucus from glands near its gills, creating a cocoon. This will protect the parrotfish from parasites and is also thought to trap any telltale scent of its hiding place. Within an hour, his work is done. It's just in time. White-tipped reef sharks are night hunters. And they are hungry. With snake-like bodies and a collapsible dorsal fin, they're perfectly equipped to squeeze through a labyrinth of tunnels. Scouring the reef, they follow scent trails to locate prey. When they found a victim, they can be known to work together, trapping exits and shepherding stray fish to their deaths. But for these predators, there's more than one way to catch a fish. If a meal eludes them, they have another sense in reserve. Electroreceptors on their head can detect an animal's bioelectrical energy. Even the tiniest electrical signal, as small as the heartbeat of a frightened fish, will reveal a hiding place. The sharks pass. The parrotfish doesn't move a muscle. Against the super senses of these night stalkers, the parrotfish stood no chance. Indonesia's waters conceal many secrets. Predators have evolved to be successful hunters, and their prey has had to learn how to hide.